You found your perfect house, but you still own your home. What should you do? Welcome back to another episode of our series, 60 Lessons That We've Learned in 60 Years. And today we're going to talk about, should you sell your home before you buy another one? So there's a few different strategies depending on your budget and what your options are. I mean, ideally, you know, yes, sell your home before you buy. If you have the option of an interim housing so that you can make a strong offer with your home already sold, so that the seller on the flip side has more deal certainty. Mm-hmm. Now for families and other people, that's just not practical. So
it's not easy, yeah.
Right, so should you sell your home before you buy? Well, we have some strategies and some options.
Mm-hmm. I mean, one of the options is the kickout clause. I mean, explain how the kickout clause works.
Okay, so you have your house on the market, and it's a home sale contingency with your offer, and then you have a 72-hour kickout clause. And what that kickout clause does is you're in primary position, you're moving forward, you're getting the home inspection, you're making loan application, you're getting the appraisal. The normal stuff. Mm-hmm. But if a backup offer comes in that's acceptable to the seller, now you have 72 hours to remove your home sale contingency, or all contingencies actually, and move forward. So it gives you like a first right of refusal. Yep. That's what we primarily see. And a lot of times once you get so far into that process, I mean, you have a term, don't shoot the hen that's gonna lay the egg. Mm-hmm. If they're already so far along, a lot of times the seller's not gonna accept a backup offer and let that, especially if their house is under mm-hmm. contract, you know, let that closing, you know, happen.
Or we've seen them where they accept them as a backup and ask them to stay as a backup offer. Yeah, so it pushes the first offer to closing mm-hmm. without removing the contingencies.
And then another option is, well, if the house you're buying, if it's owned for free and clear, can they do some owner financing? That way you can close while you still have your house, and then it makes the move a little bit easier. You can do improvements and you can move over time rather than, you know, having your moving truck at the closing table, mm-hmm. waiting to get keys to go to the next property, which is really stressful.
Exactly. And then another option is a bridge loan. So you go to your local lender and say, hey, I want to borrow some equity out of the house that I live in. I want to borrow a little bit of money out of the new one I'm buying. You combine the two and you're able to get you're going to end up paying two mortgages for a short period of time. But if you price the first house, your primary house, correctly, it'll be sold in probably 30 to 45 days. So it's usually a pretty, pretty safe bet.
Bridges the gap.
Mm-hmm. It absolutely does. All right. Well, thank you so much for watching us. You know, we always appreciate your comments. Next week, we've got an interesting lesson on real estate. Join us next week.
If you're enjoying our videos and our topics, subscribe to our YouTube channel or like our Facebook page for our weekly videos.